time, the Sunshine Choir is coming, and we have several numbers for you.
Thank you.
reading out of Matthew chapter 1, verse 18. This is how Jesus, the Messiah, was born. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph, but before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her fiancé, was a good man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David," the angel said, "do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet. "Look, the virgin will conceive a son. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." This song says God is with us.
Thank you. I'm reading out of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 and 7. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen. And then there's one other passage I want to read to you. This is written, penned by Isaiah 700 years before the coming of Jesus. It said, "All right then, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She'll give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." At this time, we have the Hallelujah Chorus, and it's customary to stand on this. But today, we're going to ask you to be seated because there is a banner display coming in, okay? So you remain seated on this.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. He shall reign forever and ever. Hallelujah. At this Christmas season, we remember him as a baby born in a manger. God saw fit. God saw fit in his sovereignty that he would send Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. He is God with us. He came as a baby, but now he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And he's going to rule forever and ever. Hallelujah. His kingdom will never end. His kingdom will never end. And I want to challenge you at this Christmas season. I want to challenge you, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, that you would personally, we know it's a historical fact that he came. It's a historical fact that Jesus came. But has he come to your heart and life? Has he transformed and changed your heart and life? Does he live inside you by the power of his Holy Spirit? Have you experienced a new regeneration? Having your life changed by his power? He wants to do that. He wants this to be the very best Christmas you've ever had, because he is living inside of you and he is directing your life. You know, many times people look at religious folk and say, well, they're just radical. There's something different about them. Well, I can tell you the transformation, the change that comes because Christ comes to live within us. There is a regeneration, there is a birth, a new birth inside of us that forever changes us, that makes us right with God. Thank God that he came, that there is peace on earth, goodwill to men. But that peace on earth, goodwill to men is for those who will receive him. And so if you've never received him as your Savior and Lord, invite him in. Invite him in and say, Jesus, come in and change my life and transform me. And I challenge you this year, just a few days before Christmas, I challenge you, make time. Make time for him in your life. Make time. Make room. Make room for him in your life. And this will be the best Christmas season you'll ever have if you'll make time for him and make time for those around you. It's amazing how God puts each of us in places to touch other people. And may we be his hand extended. May we be his feet. May we be his hand extended this Christmas season. Will you stand with me this morning?